Dear students, previous classes we will discuss about what is meaning of guttation, what is meaning of transpiration, what is meaning of stomata. Dear students, once again repeated to the guttation, transpiration and stomata. Listen here. Guttation means the loss of water in its liquid form, that is called guttation. Guttation are mainly shown in grassland plants and many herbaceous plants. Transpiration means the loss of water from the aerial parts of the plant body. Form the vapor, that is called the transpiration. Stomata means the smaller size of minute pores are appeared in the epidermal cells of the leaves, that is called the stomata. That is called the stomata. Dear students, the dicotyledon plants of leaves are having greater number of stomata, mainly in lower surface of the epidermis than the upper epidermis of the leaves. The monocotyledon leaves have equal number of stomata or in the both surfaces or in the both surfaces. Anyhow, in dicotyledons, the stomata of god cells are to be appeared bean shaped or kidney shaped, but in monocotyledons the god cells are appeared dumbbell shape, the dumbbell shape. So each stomata consists of stomata fore or stomata upper tube, two god cells and subsidiary cells. What is the functioning of stomata? Besides transpiration, the stomata is always exchange of gases such as oxygen and carbon dioxide is always exchanged in outside to inside of the cells. Outside to inside of the cells. That is the importance of guttation, transpiration and stomata. Dear students, today we are going to discuss about mechanism in opening and closing of stomata. Dear students, Levin proposed K plus pump theory, that is potassium ions. Levin proposed K plus pump theory in the mechanism of stomata opening and closing occurs during the photoactive stomata. Photoactive stomata. Dear students, the stomata opening and closing in there involved mainly some ions such as K plus ions, that is potassium ions, Cl minus ions, that is chloride ions, H plus, that is protons, and decrease and increasing of water potential, decreasing and increasing of pH value. These are the mainly involved in opening and closing of stomata. Opening and closing of stomata. Dear students, Levin proposed a K plus pump theory to be explained the mechanism of opening and closing of stomata occurs during the photoactive stomata. The photoactive stomata. Dear students, already in previous classes we will detailed discuss about two types of stomatas. First one is photoactive stomata. Second one is scotoactive stomata. Dear students, photoactive stomata means the stomata open during daytime and the stomata closing during night time in the presence of light. That is called photoactive stomata. Okay, right? And the scotoactive stomata, the stomata opening during night time and the stomata closing during daytime in the absence of light. That is called scotoactive stomata. Okay, now right. These are the two differences between photoactive stomata and scotoactive stomata. Scotoactive stomata is always reversible to the photoactive stomata. So, dear students, Levitt proposed in a K plus pump theory to be explained the mechanism of opening and closing of stomata occurs during the photoactive stomata. Anyhow, the stomata opening and closing mainly depend upon to the some K plus ions, some Cl minus ions and protons, and then after the decrease and increasing of water potential and decrease and increasing of pH value and also water stress conditions and one of the growth regulator such as abscisic acid. These are involved in the opening and closing of stomata. Dear students, first we are going to discuss about opening of stomata. Opening of stomata. Dear students, this is a blood cell. This is a blood cell. Okay, now. So, this blood cell already containing protons. And blood cells is surrounded by some of the subsidiary cells. These subsidiary cells containing K plus and Cl minus ions. K plus and Cl minus ions. So, dear students, according to this theory, the accumulation of K plus and Cl minus ions to be moved outside of the cell to inside of the blood cells. Outside of the cells, that is subsidiary cells, to the inside of the blood cells. Inside of the blood cells. That is known as influx. That is known as influx. Dear students, this is a blood cell. This blood cell already containing some amount of protons, and this blood cell is surrounded by some of the subsidiary cells. These subsidiary cells are having to some ions such as K plus and Cl minus ions. K plus and Cl minus ions. So, some ions to be moved outside of the cells to inside of the cells. That is, these ions to be moved blood cells from the subsidiary cells. These ions to be moved into the blood cells from the subsidiary cells. That is known as influx. Influx. Influx means some ions to be moved outside of the cell to inside of the cell. Outside of the cell to inside of the cell. That is called influx. By means these ions to be moved subsidiary cells to blood cells. Subsidiary cells to blood cells. Okay now. So next one. So the coupling of protons to be efflux. To be efflux. By means, so the blood cells already containing protons. By means, so the protons to be moved inside of the cell to outside of the cell. By means, the protons to be moved blood cells to the subsidiary cells. Blood cells to the subsidiary cells. That is called efflux. That is called efflux. of the pH value and decreasing of the water potential to be increasing of the pH value and to be decreasing of the water potential and also suddenly water thereby enters to the guar cells, enters to the guar cells. These guar cells are stressed by inner wall of the pores, inner wall of the pores. Then the stomata pore become tuggy or the stomata is suddenly to be opening. That is opening of stomata. That is opening of stomata in the presence of sunlight. In the presence of sunlight. This is a opening of stomata. And closing of stomata. So closing of stomata is reversible to opening of stomata. So dear students, closing of stomata. So the guar cell already containing K plus and Cl minus ions, but the guar cells are not containing protons. So dear students, so in the absence of sunlight during night time, but during day time, so during day time the stomata is opening to be moved the influx of K plus Cl minus ions and to be moved the influx of protons. At the same time increasing of pH value and decreasing of water potential. At night, in the absence of sunlight, the efflux of K plus Cl minus ions and the influx of protons and increasing of the water potential and decreasing of the pH value. Increasing of the water potential and decreasing of the pH value. So then the guar cells of the water to be returned up to subsurface cells, to be returned up to subsurface cells, then become the stomata pore is plastic. The stomata pore is plastic by means of the stomata is closing. The stomata is closing. That is closing up to stomata. Okay now. So dear students, so already the guar cells containing K plus Cl minus ions. So inside of the K plus Cl minus ions to be moved outside of the cells. By means, so these ions to be moved guar cells to the subsurface cells. That is efflux. That is efflux. Reversible. And outside of the protons to be moved inside of the guar cells. That is influx. That is influx. Okay now. So in this time to be decreasing of the pH value but increasing of the water potential. There is no pressure of the inner wall of the stomata to be pore and at the same time to be removal of water molecules and other substances again to become subsurface cells. So suddenly the stomata is plastic. There is no any pressure. That is closing of stomata. That is closing of stomata. So this is about opening and closing of stomata. Opening and closing of stomata. Dear students, mainly differences between the opening and closing of stomata. First, we will discuss about the opening of stomata. Mainly involved in plus K plus Cl minus ions and efflux protons and decreasing of water potential and increasing of pH value in the presence of sunlight during daytime. Next we are going to closing of stomata. Closing of stomata. So mainly involved efflux of K plus Cl minus ions and and influx of protons. Water potential is increase, pH value is decrease at night in the absence of sunlight. In the absence of sunlight. And at the same time, the closing of stomata are not only involved efflux, K plus, L minus ions, influx protons, and decreasing of pH value and increasing of water potential, and also to be involved water stress conditions and abscisic acid is an antitranspirant. These are antitranspirant. So in this time, the K plus ions to be easily drives out of the blood cells. To be easily drives out of the blood cells, then become plastic, and making a stomata totally closing. This is a opening and closing of stomata in photoactive stomata. This mechanism is proposed by Leavitt. Another one here, in most of the succulent plants, especially some of the xerophytic plants such as cacti and bryophyllum. So in those plants, the stomata opening night, but stomata closing day time. All mesophytic plants, especially photoactive stomata, the stomata opening during daytime and the stomata opening during close night time. But in all succulent plants, especially some xerophytic plants, few of cacti and bryophyllum, the stomata opening during night, the stomata closing during daytime. Why? Because so night time to be making the accumulation of organic acids, then the stomata is purging, so is always opening, Okay, now in all succulent plants, the accumulation of organic material or organic acid to be made at night time. So to be making a turgid, suddenly the stomata pore is open. So that is stomata is open during at night time. Already night time in the absence of sunlight, but to be making some organic acid in the night time. That is stomata is opening night time and stomata is closing day time. So this is about the mechanism in opening and closing of stomata. Okay, now thank you.